Hi everyone, Cody here. So I'm at the local thrift store and I'm looking at glass things. And I'm mainly looking for things that have a gold trim or a gold plating on them. So I'm going to try to see if I can extract the gold from this sort of thing here. Got some little cups with some gold trim on them. Let's get those. I mean, I'm absolutely not going to get more gold out of it than this is going to cost me, but you guys get the idea. Okay, so here's what we've picked up around the place. Let's go see if we can get the gold off. So I've got the glass home and it's time to start extracting the gold from it. I think I spent about $30 total on all of these little gold-plated items. Bought a couple of other things, but here's the receipt. And there's no way I'm gonna make that much back on it. I'll be quite happy if I get $3 back. But the whole idea is to show you guys the process, which should be pretty simple. I'm just gonna put them over here into this plastic bin, then I'm gonna smerge them in a cyanide solution to dissolve the gold. So the first thing I've done is added a light, because this is probably gonna go into the night, my time-lapse camera, and put on some gloves. And right now, I'm adding some water to the reaction vessel. The next thing to do is to add some sodium hydroxide. This will keep the solution basic and will dissolve any oils that are covering the gold surfaces. Now for the sodium cyanide, I'm just gonna add in a couple of chunks of that. That's probably fine. Now I'm going to add in some activated carbon to absorb the gold from solution. So this is basically the carbon in pulp method. Now let's let this fill up with water, then I'm going to add in some hydrogen peroxide. You see, oxygen is needed for the reaction to occur and dissolve the gold. Hydrogen peroxide adds a whole bunch of oxygen to the solution. You can see the peroxide is reacting with various things and producing lots of little oxygen bubbles. So it's been a couple of hours, and let's have a look at this and see how it's coming along. So it looks like this cup here, bring this over into the light. Yeah, you can see that the solution is definitely dissolving the gold. That's good. I was kind of worried that it would be too dilute. Looks like we're good. So I'm just gonna kind of stir this around a little bit, turn over the cups so they can get the other side, give everything a good mix, and then I guess I'll just let it go for the rest of the night. I'll probably stop the time-lapse camera because there's not going to be much really going on overnight, probably. Yeah, this little cup here is completely done. Excellent. So it's the next day, and it appears that most of the gold has been dissolved, as you can see. So now I'm just removing these dishes from the gold dissolving bath, and I'm putting it over here to rinse off the cyanide. Now, to destroy the cyanide, I just use a little bit of household gene destroyer here, a little splash of this, and no more cyanide. Then I'm just putting the rinse dishes over here in this box, and I'll either reuse them or just take them straight back to the thrift store. Yeah, that particular plate does have a little bit of gold on it, but I think it was actually mixed in with the glaze, and so it's really not worth my time to try to remove, because I'd have to like grind the plate up.
How do you know it was gold?
Well, in general, if there's like a gold trim on the glass, it's probably gold, because gold's actually the easiest material to put on, and they're not going to be putting on more than a few cents worth at a time. So what are we going to do with the plates now?
Well, I don't know about the plates, but I'm going to make some cocoa.
Okay. So now what I should have is a very dilute solution of gold cyanide. But rather, I'm actually hoping that the gold cyanide is absorbed onto the carbon by now. The reason I decided to do it in this method, with it as diluted as it is so that I can determine if this process would actually work for extracting small quantities of gold. You see, the ore in my mine is going to have probably about the same amount of gold as those dishes did. You know, by volume, even. So if I can extract the gold from this, then I'll know that I'll be able to extract it from the mine. So I'm actually going to give this a stir every now and then, let it absorb onto the carbon for a little bit longer. See, there's quite a bit of carbon down at the bottom there. It's probably way more carbon than I needed, but I wanted to make sure I got all the gold. Before burning the charcoal to ash, I'm actually going to grind it up into a fine powder so it'll burn quicker. Okay, so I'm just going to put the crushed carbon into the furnace on top of a plate, just like that. Now let it get red hot for several hours to burn away the carbon. We'll see what happens. So you guys might be wondering how I know that the activated carbon absorbed all of the gold from the solution. Well, first of all, activated carbon absorbs down into the microgram per liter level, so that's insane. But also, I have a little test here, which I'm gonna perform, that should be very sensitive for detecting small quantities of gold. But before I can do this test, I gotta get rid of the cyanide. So I have a small sample of the cyanide solution here, and now I'm actually gonna acidify it with a little bit of hydrochloric acid. Now, I know almost everywhere you read says that you should never let the acidity of a cyanide solution go above 5 or whatever, because the cyanide will react producing hydrogen cyanide gas, which is true, but hydrogen cyanide is incredibly soluble in water, which means that basically by acidifying it, I've not actually done much to it. There's still cyanide in solution. Much the same way that you'd have carbon dioxide dissolved into solution. Now heat the solution to drive off the rest of the cyanide. Now the quantity that's going to be here is so small that if I just let it go up into the air, it's not going to hurt anything. There you go, those bubbles are probably actually the hydrogen cyanide gas. Okay, now I've boiled the water for a little while. And it's becoming very hard for me to hold. I should have all the cyanide removed from the solution. So now I'm just going to drop in a little bit of stannous chloride. And if we see a color change to a light purple, then we'll know there's still gold. If not, I know I got most of the gold out. Here we go. In goes the stannous. I did not see a noticeable color change, so I know that there's hardly any gold in solution.
So, I wasn't able to see the bottle you were...
Oh, this bottle?
Yeah, do you want to do that again?
This is stannous chloride right here. You notice it's basically just hydrochloric acid with a little bit of stannous chloride dissolved in it along with a piece of tin to keep it fresh. Okay. Looks like it's almost completely burned up. It's very good. It's the next day. I've let everything cool off. I'm actually amazed at how well this plate is held up. It's kind of stuck in there, but otherwise the plate is okay, and all the carbon is now converted to ash. And actually, it's got a slightly reddish color to it. That tells me there might be some minerals in it. Excellent. At some point, I should probably show the process of how to extract the gold from the activated carbon without burning it. Unfortunately, that process requires temperatures of 170 degrees Celsius and concentrated cyanide solutions. That process is, of course, way more difficult than just burning the carbon. So the process of getting gold out of the ash is basically a miniature fire assay. I've shown that process many times, and I think this time I'll just show a quick time lapse and we'll just skip to the part where I show the gold. So it looks like there's a bit of gold down in there. Let's pull it out and get a better look at it. There's my gold. Now that's pretty. And you know what? That might actually be enough I could actually put on the scale and weigh it. Exciting. So this proves that I can actually extract that low quantity of gold. Okay, let's grab this, set it over here on the scale. There it is. All right, about 30 milligrams. That's not bad. It's about what I expected. That's cool. So let's see, at a price of $40 per 1,000 milligrams, that'd be $4 per 100 milligrams, and this is about a third of 100, that means I've got a little over a dollar worth of gold here. How about that? Hope you all enjoyed. I'll see you next time.